Hi guys, this is John here. In today's lecture, I will show you how we understand the concepts of hovering and how you can make a drone hover and how it is related to the same concept we saw in our previous practical session where we adjusted the thrust of the motors to the weight. So let me show you how this works. So let me increase the weight to 1.5 kilos and let the maximum thrust be 5. So now you will see that as I increase the thrust of all the four motors, keep your eyes on the total motor thrust and the weight of the drone. Now as it increases, the minute it goes above 15 newtons, you will see that the drone starts moving up. And if I keep it just as it is, you will see that the drone continues to move up as we saw in the theory lecture. So now the question is, how do I stop it from keep going up? Basically, I have to reduce the thrust. So if you see, if I reduce the thrust, the drone stops going up. And if I keep it that way, you will see that the drone actually starts moving down. So now the question is, how do I keep it at one place? I have to maintain a balance of up and down. I have to keep increasing, keep decreasing. And that is the challenge. That is the true challenge faced by the controller, where you have to make sure that the thrust is going up, going down, going up, going down, going up, going down. And that's how the balance is maintained. And this is done by the controller of your drone to hover in one position. So if you see that the total thrust keep going up and down, if you observe the total thrust keeps going up and down, and but the drone is still maintained at one place, and that is not easy for the controller. But what I'm trying to tell you is that is how challenging it is for the controller to maintain the drone at one position. And this I want you to try practically. So if I bring the drone back down, you will see that the drone came back down because the total thrust was lesser. So let's reset this again. Let me go ahead and increase the weight again to 1.6. Now let me increase the thrust again. So you will see when the thrust crosses 16, the drone will start moving up. And if I don't do anything, it will continue to move up as we saw in the theory lecture. Now for me to stop this from moving up and hover at one place, I have to reduce the thrust down again, as you see on the right. Then I increase the thrust again to maintain it at one position. Then I reduce it once again. Then it keeps going. Then I increase again. Then I reduce. I increase. I reduce. And that's the cat and mouse game that the controller has to play with the drone, because the weight is never constant. It keeps adjusting a little bit. And for that, as the controller of the drone, you have to keep maintaining this exercise. And that is where the real trick is for you as the controller of the drone. So effectively, what have we seen? To first make the drone go up, we increase the thrust. So when we increase the thrust and when the total thrust is more than the weight of the drone goes up. The drone goes up. Now for me to stop the drone from continuously going up, I have to reduce the thrust, as you see. And now to keep it balanced at one place, I have to make sure that I increase the thrust. I reduce it again. I increase the thrust, I reduce it again. So that cat and mouse game I want you to try. It's not easy, I know that. Now you will understand as a student how the controller of the drone has to continuously adjust the thrust of all the four motors so that it can keep the drone hovered at one place. And as you will see in the challenges that we have set for you in the simulator, there is one challenge on hovering the drone at a particular height. So what I would like you to do is practice your hovering. And again, just to summarize, for you to hover, first, you will have to increase your thrust so that the drone goes up. Then once you have reached your height, you have to make sure that you reduce your thrust. The drone will come down, you keep increasing and reducing. Keep reducing and increasing, and that's how you will get it right. And now you see, I keep reducing and increasing, and that's how it will work. So now this is not going to be easy initially, but what I want you to do is, I want you to try this out in a way where you understand with your own hands, how do I control my drone? And that will give you a good understanding of how to hover. Now, when you will go into the learning zone, we have kept some challenges for you. So level 1 to level 4 is all about hovering, where you have to complete a challenge where you are given the drone and you have to fly the drone between the two discs for a minimum time of 10 seconds or more. So flying between the two discs is basically you have to hover the drone, and I want you to go ahead and try that. I'm not going to try this level for you, but it's the same concept where you have to start flying the drone. You will find these two discs, and between these two discs, the discs will turn green. You have to hover this between the two discs. I'm purposely not solving this for you because I want you to try this learning level. But it's the same concept. To hover between the two discs, you will have to keep adjusting and reducing your thrust. And I'm purposely not solving this for you because then you will know the answer. But I want you to try this level on your own. But this level basically uses the same concepts that we have learnt in this lecture, which is increasing the thrust and reducing the thrust. So please go ahead and try that also. But I would request you to please practice this before you try the challenge. And the more time you spend between the discs, the more points you will get. So you can go back and try this again. So in today's lecture, we have understood how to hover the drone at a particular height. So what I want you to try is practice this properly and then go back to your learning zone and also complete your challenges. I hope this lecture was clear to you guys. I'll see you guys in the next lecture. Thank you.